In today's video, 6 things you might not know about Adobe Illustrator and what they can do. So follow along and see how many of them you've actually learned right here in today's video. As designers, we spend a lot of our time online and dealing with sensitive information and content. A dash lane helps keep that information secure, and it saves you time within your workflow by storing your passwords and your delicate information all in one location. To learn more about Dashlane and how it can help you secure and speed up your workflow, stay tuned to the very end of the video and also grab a 30-day free trial of the premium version. So welcome back to Satori Graphics, everybody, and we are back in my second home, Adobe Illustrator. The first function in Adobe Illustrator that you might not know about relates to the live corners, which you can only use if you have Illustrator CC. You can find the live corners here, and by using the direct selection tool, which is A on your keyboard, you can round the corners off like so, which is really basic stuff, and that's not what the tip is actually about. The tip here is that you can double-click the live corners to bring up this dialog box. You now have new options that allow you to change the style of the corner, and you have some measurements to adjust and alter it as well. And this was hiding behind a double-click the entire time. Also, however, you can use the standard selection tool, which is V on your keyboard, and then double-click to bring up the transform window instantly. This will allow you to transform your shapes as a whole. So that was the first thing you might not know about Illustrator, so let's move on to more geeky goodness. So we've swapped up a square for a circle, and for this one we're going to look at a neat function that uses gradients. We're going to add a gradient to our stroke, but in a very specific way. So if you want to toggle the stroke and the fill, simply press X, and that will change the color palette selection. But anyway, for this effect, make a gradient, and then make sure to use the apply a gradient along a stroke, which is the middle box in the gradient window. You then want to increase the stroke weight as a whole, and I actually didn't click the gradient along a stroke option. But yeah, okay, so keep increasing the stroke weight until the hole in the middle of your shape disappears. This leaves you with a really neat outcome, and this actually does work for all kinds of different shapes. But let's move on to the next addition in today's tutorial. And for this one, you do again need Illustrator CC, because I'm going to show you a neat way to use the freeform gradient tool. Now for this one, you want to open up the gradient window, and also the swatches panel too, and these can both be found under the window drop-down menu. Now we need the swatches panel open because we're going to make a global swatch, which will be part of this neat function I'm going to show you when using the freeform gradient tool. So drag a color into the swatches panel from the colors palette, and then double click it so you can activate the global swatch option. Using the ellipse tool, I'm going to make a circle so I can actually demonstrate the next step. So you can add a gradient fill in the color palettes, or just go directly to the gradient in the gradient window. And we want to make use of the freeform gradient. Now, the lines option is so much better than the spots option in my personal opinion, and so we're going to be using that. If I select a node, and then I choose my global swatch color, I can continue to make a line around my design like so. The lines option gives you more freedom to position your gradient in a very precise way, as opposed to just using spot colors. Now if I finish up my design here, I'm going to reveal why the global swatch option is very handy. Say if I want to change the color of each point on my line, it would take a lot of time to individually click each color on the line and change it. So what I can do is simply just double click the swatch color and then adjust it from here, which will change the entire color across the line. Now personally speaking, this is one of the best ways to use the freeform gradient tool in Illustrator in most situations. The next thing you might not know about Illustrator is a quick way to make a color scheme and to create visual harmony with color. you're going to find that in the color guide, which is located here. Now clicking the fly down menu will show you all of the color schemes and the choices that you have. And this feature is so useful in Illustrator. It's something I use on a regular basis in my workflow. So let's take the base color of this logo and then create a monochromatic selection using it. Holding down the Alt Option key and then clicking and dragging will duplicate my design. And then I just hit Command or Control plus D, which is going to repeat the process. And using the color guide window makes life so much easier when selecting and using colors in Adobe Illustrator. And it's something I feel every single designer can make good use of. Color is very important when it comes to designs, and it can make or break a design, as a matter of fact. The next function in Illustrator is a quick one, but it's really handy to know, and many of you probably already know it. But if you want to place a design or an object in the direct center of the artboard, there are various different ways to do that. But one quick way is to open up the Align window, and then set the alignment to Align to Artboard. Now we can center anything to the exact center very, very easily and also quickly. Also, we can align things to the edges of the artboard as well. So the next aspect of Illustrator that you might not know about is something quite fun to experiment with. So firstly, before that, we can add some more anchor points to a shape or a design, and you can do that in the Path menu right here. Now I'm actually going to do this two times, in fact. So in the Effects menu, you will find something labeled Pucker and Bloat. This can make some very interesting vector designs in a matter of seconds, depending on your shape and the amount of anchor points that you're using. So check the preview option and then see what kind of results you get. This last one is kind of a bit of fun and it's interesting to experiment with. A dash lane is an application that can save your passwords and your vital information in one secure location, as well as saving you time in your design workflow, so you don't have to keep resetting your passwords every time you forget them. You can download the dash lane app on one device for a lifetime totally for free, and then secure everything with one master password. The neat thing is that Dashlane doesn't actually store your master password, so even if there is a hack, the encryption will prevent your data from being compromised. Now another cool feature that will save you time in your workflow is the autofill function when filling out forms online. Now you can probably relate to my distaste for these forms because I encounter them pretty much daily, and this tends to eat into my time as a graphic designer over the course of days and weeks. Dashlane can autofill these forms with your information in an instant, which means I have more time to focus on my business and my clientele work. There are other cool features of Dashlane, such as alerting you to when there is someone trying to hack your accounts, a password manager that tells you the health of your passwords, a VPN service to remain anonymous online, and so much more. And you can download the free version of the Dashlane app to one device for life, but the premium version can be downloaded to unlimited devices for a lifetime. Using my link, you're going to have access to the premium version of Dashlane for 30 days as a trial. So do check out Dashlane link down below and start securing and optimizing your online life and career as a graphic designer today. And if you do want to keep boosting your skills as a graphic designer, do remember to subscribe to my channel for weekly graphic design content. And of course, until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.